JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for June the 25th. I am Charalambos Pissouros, senior market analyst here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. We'll leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar continued to slide against the majority of the other major currencies on Thursday and during the Asian session Friday. It lost the most ground versus NZD, AUD and CHF in that order, while it decked out gains only versus the British pound and the Canadian dollar. Now, the weakening of the US dollar and the strengthening of the risk-linked Aussie and Kiwi suggest that markets traded in a risk-on fashion yesterday and today in Asia. However, the strengthening of the Swiss franc and the weakening of the loonie point otherwise. Thus, in order to get a clearer picture with regards to the broader market sentiment, we prefer to turn our gaze to the equity world. Here we see that major EU and US indices were a sea of green, with the S&P 500 and Nasdaq hitting fresh record highs. The increased risk appetite rolled over into the Asian session today as well. Following Wednesday's slide, EU shares rebounded strongly on Thursday, confirming our view that with the ECB staying adamant that it is not time to start withdrawing monetary policy support yet, the latest setback could prove to be just a corrective phase. A dovish stance by the Bank of England may have also helped sentiment during the European trading to improve. The bank decided to keep its policy settings unchanged, with only one member voting in favor of quantitative easing tapering. That member was Chief Economist Andy Haldane, for whom this was the last meeting. The bank repeated that the surge in inflation is expected to be transitory, and added that they do not want to undermine their the recovery by premature tightening, disappointing those expecting signals that something like that could be announced at the next gathering. The outcome also affected the British pound, which was yesterday's main loser. So, with the Bank of England decision in mind, and also taking into account concerns over the spreading of the Delta coronavirus variant in the UK, we cannot rule out further retreat in this currency, especially against the commodity-linked ones, Aussie and Kiwi, which we expect to stay under some buying interest in case the broader market sentiment stays supported as well. Later in the US, investors' appetite remained improved, and that continued during the Asian session today as well, perhaps after US President Joe Biden embraced a bipartisan Senate infrastructure deal, which may help to extend the recovery in the world's largest economy. Today, though, investors are likely to turn their gaze to the core PCE index, which is the Fed's favorite inflation metric, in order to form a better opinion on what the Fed's future plans may be. This inflation index is expected to have risen to 3.4% year-over-year in May from 3.1%, further above the committee's objective of 2%, something that could raise more questions as to whether the latest surge in headline inflation is indeed due to transitory factors. Speculation over a potential rate hike as early as next year could increase again, something that may result in a new setback in equities and another rebound in the US dollar. Now, as for the rest of today's events, alongside the core PCE index, we also get personal income and spending for May. Income is expected to have decreased 2.5% month over month after slumping 13.1% in April, while spending is anticipated to have slowed to 0.4% month over month from 0.5%. The final University of Michigan Consumer Sentiment Index for June is also due to be released, and it is expected to confirm its preliminary estimate of 86.4. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 7 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, a greater weekend, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again next week.
JFT, just fair and direct.